Here's our final product. It's a real-time subscriber counter, and as you can see right now, we have 102,758 subscribers.
Super exciting. This thing is just a Raspberry Pi Zero. It's not connected to a computer. This is just a power wire, but it's fetching data through the YouTube data API and just displaying it on the screen. We did have to add this extra wire in here because the LED matrixy things are drawing a little bit too much power. But apart from that, it's pretty nice and compact.
But you might have noticed that this bar is pretty wide. It's not because we're expecting a million subscribers.
Although it'd be pretty nice if we got there.
It would. With all the news recently about cryptocurrencies and Bitcoin going way up and down, we decided that we could use this to be a crypto ticker as well.
If you want to know how we made this thing, there's going to be a full write-up on hackster.io. We'll have all the 3D printable parts, the code, the materials, and all the instructions so that you can build one of your own. But 100,000 subscribers is a really amazing achievement. It's such a huge number that I really can't even comprehend it. And we couldn't have done it without you guys. You know, when we first started this, we were just a couple of dudes making a bartender in my apartment.
And now we're just a couple of dudes making projects in this dark garage. Speaking of the bartender, one of the number one comments on our videos is asking when we're going to finish our bartender.
I can see it. It's right there. We haven't forgot about it.
It's tucked away in a corner of our garage.
Yeah. Well, the problem is, and I think I might have commented this on some video, but basically we thought the linear actuators that were running the liquor dispensers were actuator or solenoids, but they were actually motors. So when we got our new power supply, we fired it up and we actually burnt out all of our linear actuators because they were motors that were held at stall current. So to continue the bartender, we have to find some new linear actuators that are actually solenoids, and just haven't gotten around to it.
Right, but we think we have a lot more cool projects lined up, so it's not at the top of our list, but we may get to it eventually.
Yeah, we have a lot of cool stuff planned for 2018, so stay tuned, and we'll just say that our projects are going to get bigger and better.
So in honor of our 100,000 subscriber mark, we decided to post on Instagram and ask you guys if you had any burning questions you had about us.
So if you're not following us on Instagram, make sure to do that, because we post a lot of behind the scenes photos and videos. But let's see here. The first question is, what is your favorite inventor? By Foreign Spy.
You go first.
I go first. Okay, so my favorite inventor is probably Nikola Tesla. He was really far ahead of his time. He's kind of known as like a futurist of the early electricity days. And one of the coolest inventions that he made was this like wireless electricity generator. So you could stand by it, like when this thing fired up, you could stand by it with a light bulb and it would turn on because it was just transmitting electricity through the air. Really cool invention. I'd recommend looking it up.
I'd say my favorite inventor is probably Tony Stark. He was once in a warehouse and using a bunch of scrap parts put together a full body suit of armor with weapons, and that's like a DIY god, so we can only hope to ever be as great as him.
A little less serious answer, but I like it. All right, sorry if I'm mispronouncing this name, but it's Devashish 6694. Will you be making something related to artificial intelligence in the future? Love your videos. Keep it up. Yes, we will always be making videos about artificial intelligence. Super interesting and cool. If you guys have any ideas for things that you want to see us build, just leave ideas in the comments and we'll try to build them. DNT Blink 101 asks, AI platform for cars? Which OS? Best hardware? So assuming he wants to build some sort of autonomous vehicle.
Okay, well, we're not super familiar with the best platform for these type of projects. We do have a project in the future lined up that's going to involve something along these lines, though. We do have right now in our hands something called a sensor sweep.
Not actually in our hands, but... We own a scan sweep.
Scan sweep.
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's like a $300 LiDAR, which is pretty cheap and works pretty well.
So we'll probably use that in our videos. But I don't really know of any like OS projects out there. I'm sure if you Google it, you could probably find something. All right. So the next question is by Zachariah Barkring.
Yeah, close enough.
Sorry if we're mispronouncing that. What is the job of your dream?
Well, my dream job is probably doing that job that the guy on the show Silicon Valley does, where he goes up on the rooftop and hangs out and gets paid a lot of money for doing not a lot of things.
Yeah, that sounds like a great job. My favorite job would probably be, I don't know, I wouldn't really say that there's like a specific thing I would want to do. Just I would want to have a lot of creative freedom to like build whatever I want to build. Oh, it's not as cool as yours, but so Danny G 00 asks, how'd you guys get started making? Basically Davis and I knew each other when we were in high school, and we've always just kind of liked building stuff. We used to make videos too, so it just kind of went hand in hand. And then we randomly just both got a job. We live in California, so we both got a job out in California and decided that we wanted to make stuff and post videos on YouTube in our free time. Do you have anything you want to say about that?
Sounds like a true story.
Yeah, okay. Danny G 00 also asks, who lives in the hacker house?
Who lives in the hacker house? That'd be me. This is my house.
Yeah. I used to live here too, but then I moved out. Now I live in an apartment somewhere else. Garth Thacker asks, can you make a video on home automation using voice on a Raspberry Pi? Yeah, I mean, we kind of already have. We made that smart mirror video. We also have a couple other home automation videos.
Yeah, but also this past Christmas, a lot of people have gotten Google Homes and Amazon Alexas for Christmas. So I think in the future, we could probably do some project that integrates that. All right, so the last question from Devashish6694 again. Why you kept your channel name Hacker House? I'm assuming he's asking, why did we name our channel Hacker House?
In case you don't know, a Hacker House is like a community of programmers or builders or makers that get together and build stuff. So we just thought it was like a fitting name and it sounded really cool.
All right, so that's it for all the questions. We'd like to thank you guys again for all of your support and helping us get to this 100,000 subscriber milestone. It really means a lot to us. We never thought we'd get here when we only had about 100 subscribers just last year.
If you haven't already, make sure to subscribe so you keep up to date with all of our projects. Like I said, there's a lot of big stuff coming in 2018, so make sure you stay tuned for that. But until then, see you next time.